Hello and welcome to Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning and I'm at the Page Museum at the La Brea Tar Pits. The La Brea Tar Pits have one of the densest fossil collections in the world. And the fossils that come out of the tar pits are very unique because of their dark color. When they're sitting in the tar for all those thousands of years, the bitumen and the asphalt in the tar seeps into the bones and all the fossils, eggs, whatever you have that is trapped in the tar being fossilized. And it leaves this dark color when they're excavated and restored and cleaned up. The dark color is permanent, can never be removed, and is one of the more unique features of fossils found at the tar pits. Many of the fossils that have been trapped in the tar exhibit very unique features that aren't found in other fossil environments. Some of these bones here exhibit signs that they have been ground against other bones or rocks while they're sinking in through the tar. This bone here has gnaw marks on it from when it was sitting on the surface and rodents were chewing at it trying to get meat out of it. This bone has been trapped on the surface for an unknown number of years, and as a result, water and the elements have chipped away at it and made it seemingly frayed. The museum collection is perhaps most famous for its assortment of dire wolf remains. More than 1,600 dire wolves have been discovered in the tar pits. This entire wall contains 404 of their best skulls that they've discovered in the tar pits. The reason there are so many dire wolves and other predators, including saber-toothed cats, in the tar pit fossil remains is that as the larger, slower herbivore and prey animals got stuck in the tar and slowly starved to death, the predators would come in and attempt to scavenge what they could off the animals. The predators, too, would often become stuck in the mud and tar and starve and die and be preserved forever in the tar pits. This has been Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning. Thank you for watching.